Hey guys, it's Lance from McVee Audio. I apologize for not putting out any videos in about, 6 months. But I'm sure nobody's holding their breath. but today I'm going to install Mavericks on my MacBook Pro, and then I'm going to test it with Pro Tools 10 and Pro Tools 11 and see if they even work with Mavericks. Mavericks just came out today, and I'm also going to time and see how long it takes to install Mavericks on my MacBook Pro. I have an SSD on there, so it should be pretty quick. And then we'll run a few tests. Okay, I'm back, and I've installed Mavericks. It took about 42 minutes and 29 seconds. I had to reboot the computer like 2 times, I think, and not because it locked up, but it just had to go through. The whole download took about 23 minutes, then it installed, then it rebooted again, and it finally finished. So now I've put in my Pro Tools HD dongle, and I'm going to try and launch Pro Tools 10. And Pro Tools 10 is launching. It's looking happy so far. Let's see. So Pro Tools launched fine. No issues there. Pro Tools 10 HD, 10.3.5 I'm on. I think it's up to 10.3.7. But I don't use my MacBook Pro that much, so it hasn't been updated. But hey, it's playing back. One track of X-Band. No idea what this is. And a few synths didn't load, but that's because they're not installed on my MacBook Pro. So there you go. Pro Tools 10 running on Mavericks. Wow, I couldn't time that better if I tried. And that's Lance from McVee Audio. And I will get around to trying out Pro Tools 11 as well, but I'm not going to do that tonight because it's not installed, and I got to go to the store and get myself a chicken because I need some chicken. Lance from McVee Audio, logging off.